Good evening and welcome to Night Prayer for this, the 23rd of October. We join together in the Lord's name this evening as we come before his word and bring to the Lord our thoughts and prayers from this day. Take up our service sheets and join together in the words. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Have a moment's quiet to reflect on the day that's been. Maybe think about things which we've done which are wrong, not according to God's will. Things we need to say sorry for and confess. Let's have a moment's quiet. Join together in the confession. Most merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and to one another that we have sinned in thought and word and deed and in what we failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Join together in the verse. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray that you with steadfast love would keep your watch around us while we sleep. From evil dreams defend our sight, from fears and terrors of the night. Tread underfoot our deadly foe, that we no sinful thought may know. O Father, that we ask be done, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, and Holy Spirit, by whose breath our souls are raised to life from death. Our reading is from Genesis chapter 40, part of the story of Joseph this evening. Joseph chapter 40. Sometime later, the cupbearer and the baker of the king of Egypt offended their master, the king of Egypt. Pharaoh was angry with the two officials, the chief cupbearer and the chief baker, and put them in custody in the house of the captain of the guard, in the same prison where Joseph was confined. The captain of the guard assigned them to Joseph, and he attended them. After they had been in custody for some time, each of the two men, the cupbearer and the baker of the king of Egypt, were being held in prison, had dreamed that same night, and each dream had a meaning of its own. When Joseph came to them the next morning, he saw that they were dejected. So he asked Pharaoh's officials, who were in custody with him in his master's house, "Why do they look so sad today?" "We both had dreams," they answered, "but there is no one to interpret them." Then Joseph said to them, "Do not interpretations belong to God? Tell me your dreams." So the chief cupbearer told Joseph his dream. He said, "In my dream I saw a vine in front of me, and on the vine were three branches. As soon as it budded, it blossomed, and the clusters ripened into grapes. Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes, squeezed them into Pharaoh's cup, and put the cup in his hand." "This is what it means," Joseph said to him. "The three branches are the 3 days. Within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head and restore you to your position, and you'll be put in Pharaoh's cup in his hand, just as you used to do when you were his cupbearer. But when all goes well with you, remember me and show me kindness. Mention me to Pharaoh and get me out of this prison. I was forcibly carried off from the land of the Hebrews, and even here I've done nothing to deserve being put in a dungeon." When the chief baker saw that Joseph had given a favourable interpretation, he said to Joseph, "I too had a dream. On my head were three baskets of bread. In the top basket were all kinds of baked goods for Pharaoh, but the birds were eaten out of the basket on my head." "This is what it means," Joseph said. The three baskets are 3 days. Within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift off your head and impale your body on a pole, and the birds will eat your flesh." Now on the third day, the Pharaoh's birthday, and he gave a feast for all his officials. He lifted up the heads of the chief cupbearer and the chief baker in the presence of his officials. He restored the chief cupbearer to his position, So he once again was put the cup in the Pharaoh's hand, but he impaled the chief baker, just as he had said in the interpretation. The chief cupbearer, however, did not remember Joseph. He forgot him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let me say a prayer. Lord God, we thank you for the story of Joseph. We thank you how your plans come to pass in your time and even through the tough times. And Lord, we pray that you would enable us to recognise where our skills and abilities lie that you have given us and use them in a mature way. Lord, through all the encounters of life, we pray that you would be at work in Jesus' name. Amen. A policeman pulls a lady over who's been speeding in America, and they wind down the window and ask her for a driving license. The officer looks at the card and says, "You know, you need glasses to be driving a car." "I have contacts," she says. "I don't care who you know," said the policeman. "You were speeding back there." Ah, having contacts, contact lenses, I think she meant. But being known and recognised is so important, isn't it? It seems to be an obsession with our nation at this time, for our country. It used to be appreciative of the understated. Now it's all glitz and glamour, isn't it? Especially on a Saturday night, whether it be dancing or whether it be singing or whatever talent you've got. You have to remember that every gift and ability that we have comes from the Lord. Every strength that we have, his source is in the Lord himself. We might put effort and work into it and hone the skills. We might work hard to develop them, but our abilities comes from the Lord. And that strength itself comes from the Lord. Joseph was a man of natural skills, lots of them. And we're going to think a little bit of that today. And remember, he was in this dark place, in this dungeon that he didn't deserve to be in. He came and he showed he was responsible, even in those tough situations. So Joseph, the father's favourite, with his fancy coat, had his parents and brothers said that in a dream that they would bow down to him. The sons have him sold into slavery and tell his father that he's been killed. And their father continues to mourn him day by day. In slavery, he's sold to Potiphar, and he does really well there. He works impeccably. But Potiphar's wife fancies him, comes on to him, and then when he rejects that, he says that he molested her. Potiphar throws him into the prison, but he does well even in that dreadful place as well. He's gone from the chosen son to being in a dreaded prison. Three things today, three things to think about, which lead to one sentence. Firstly, keep doing what you're good at. Keep doing what you're good at. I was reading the story of John Stott, who was the rector of All Souls Langham Place and did lots of wonderful work throughout the Christian world, one of the most influential Christian thinkers of the 20th century. And in his obituary, he died about 10 years ago, maybe a bit less than that. Well, in his obituary, one of his people who was discipled by him, who was also the Chancellor of Chester Diocese and a High Court judge as well, he spoke of how John Stott was a very talented man. He was a five-talent man, and he used those five talents to their ability. In fact, he was not a five-talent man because God blessed him with more. He was actually a ten-talented man. What a wonderful description. And Joseph was the same. He was a ten-talented man. Every ability that he used within the circumstances that he had, he used to their full ability. Even when he was a slave, even when he was a prisoner, worse than a slave, he still uses abilities for the benefits of other people. He waited on those in high-ranking prisoners that we had today. We get that in verse 4 from the passage. Not just out of duty, but because his story was one of care. He actually really did care for them. He had compassion. And he, as they recounted this disturbing dream, he wanted to help them. picture that has been painted is of a man who, despite two very big injustices in life, still uses skills of organisation, of compassion, of service for the benefit of other people. You know, sometimes I don't know if this happened to you, but when bad things happen to me, it makes me sometimes want to just give up. And injustice comes our way, and our energy evaporates. We don't use our skills and talents anymore. Joseph's story is a story of persistence, of keeping going, of using the skills that God had given him, despite the circumstances, to God's glory. I suppose it's truly a God-given ability to be resilient. I suppose it's a choice we make as well in our life. When things come to knock us back, that we don't just give up. We keep going. We persevere. Perseverance is commended in Paul's letters, isn't it? And Joseph's life was full of knockbacks, but he was one who persevered. Keep doing what's good. Keep doing what you're good at. Secondly, in the name of the Lord. Keep doing what you're good at in the name of the Lord. In the New Testament, there's a passage Paul speaks of how we view work, and it can transform all our energies in life. Whether it be 9 to 5, bringing up children, looking after our neighbours, caring for a sick member of our family, cutting our hedge. Whatever our energies, we use them for the glory of God. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, Paul says, Colossians 3:23. Work at it with your whole heart, as you were working for the Lord and not for men, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. And there's a little eye-opener to the story today. Maybe it's a sign of Joseph's growing in faith of the Lord God and maturing. In Potiphar's household, he recognises that going with his master's wife is morally wrong before God. Now only in verse 8, he has a revelation. He says that revelations come from God. You know, before these bad things happen, there is no mention of God in the story. And he's witnessing to these Egyptians of the one true God. One who's given promises to his grandfather Abraham, his great-grandfather Abraham. The practical care of his prisoners, the moral choices he makes, the mystical experiences of understanding the dreams and having them are all linked with God and his plans. It's great liberation to know that when we do things in the name of the Lord, it just doesn't straighten us out when we do all things to that glory. It gives us purpose. When we study the scriptures, it gives us the way that God wants us to live our life. He gives us purpose and a right way to follow. In many ways, we might enable us to answer the question, why do we do these things? Why do we live our lives in a certain way? Joseph said to these heathen Egyptians that he was not the source of the interpretation. It was God who was one. He witnessed to the reason that he was different. You know, we can do that as well. When people ask us, why do you live that way? Why do you do what you do? We can point to our Lord and Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ. So, keep doing what you're good at in the name of the Lord, even when you're not recognised. Even when you're not recognised. Translation matters, doesn't it? A few years ago, there was a signpost made in Wales, and it said on this, it was, you know, that they have to have the dual language in Wales, and it said, no lorries to go through this housing estate. And there was a big sign up on the wall that said that, no hurries to go lorries to go through the housing estate. And there was a Welsh translation underneath it, but unfortunately somebody hadn't taken the time to actually check the translation was right, because they just automatically printed up what came back from the translation unit. And the translation unit said, I'm sorry, I'm not in the office at the moment. Send any work to be translated elsewhere. Now, you know, Translation matters, doesn't it? And translation are given to the two interpretations, didn't they? The butler, the wine servant, and the baker. One was a story of restoration, and one was one of condemnation, really, wasn't it? Both came true. But despite Joseph pleading with the wine taster to remember him and the injustice that he'd suffered, he forgot all about him. Sold as a slave, living under miscarriage of justice, and now forgotten. You know, God sees everything that goes on. He sees your work that you're doing in his name, even when nobody else sees it. He saw Joseph faithfully at work, despite it seemed like everyone else forgetting him. If you think your work is worth nothing, that no one seems to be appreciating what you do, remember the Lord does. And he is the one at the end of the day who will lift up our head and say, "Well done, good and faithful servant." I'm convinced that on the last day, when we come to that great party in heaven, the glory that awaits us, those to the left and right hand side of the Lord may not be people we've heard of before. They will be those who faithfully in their lives brought witness to Jesus, and in probably a way the rest of the world doesn't recognise them at all. But the Lord is the one who does. It's not the right time for Joseph to be elevated. That was going to be a few years later. He's going to spend some time in prison. The Lord's timing was perfect. The Lord's plans came to pass, and the promises to the patriarchs came true. The Lord works through the tough times. We might not think he is. We might not see the sparks of hope, and we're feeling that at the moment through these times of disease. But the Lord's plans are good, even when they take time to come to fruition. Keep going in the work you are doing. It's worth it. Keep doing what you're good at, in the name of the Lord, even when you're not recognised. Let me pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you that you give us strength to do your work and your bidding in our world. Lord, whether there be a great or a small thing, we pray that you would enable us and strengthen us in your service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us pray. Pray, Lord God, for your world at this time. Remember those troubled areas, and we pray for peace to come. We pray for your world, Lord God, which seems to have this disease which is causing so much problem. Lord, we pray that your hand of strength will be upon us as your people. Lord, that we would demonstrate courage and wisdom in all that we do. Strengthen the medical practitioners seeking to bring an end to it, and give wisdom to our leaders, that they may follow the right paths. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray for those in need that we are aware of. And in the silence, let's lift to the Lord those known to ourselves who need his special touch at this time. Gracious Father, for those who've named in our hearts, those known only to you, Lord, who need your touch at this time, we pray your hand of blessing and strength would be upon them. Bring them healing, we pray. Your mighty hand be at work in their lives. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We pray for ourselves, Lord God, that you would strengthen us for your work and purposes in the world. Lord, may we see the Lord God, the Lord Jesus, risen, and may he be glorified in our life, in all that we do. Lord, may we continue with the skills and abilities that you have given us, so that, Lord God, that your hand would be at work in us, even when we're not recognised. May the glory go to you. Visit this place, O Lord, we pray, and drive far from it the snares of the enemy. May your holy angels dwell with us and guard us in peace. And may your blessing be always upon us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. In peace we will lie down to sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us his peace. Amen. Good night and God bless.